Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Iowa State Cyclone Dynasty here in NCAA 14. It is week 9. We are 3-3, or we are hosting the 2-4 Oklahoma State Cowboys. Let's go.
Hi everybody, Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. The Cowboys haven't only flirted with disaster, they've courted disaster, they've romanced disaster, they've married disaster, they've become one with disaster. So finally, now at rock bottom, there's only one way to go. Can they finally go up? That's going to do it for us here on the pregame show. NCAA Football 14 action coming at you right now. Brett Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
Okay, there's the pregame, the setup, the hype, and now we're left with just football to play here at Jack Trice Stadium in Ames, Iowa. You see the crowd definitely here decked out in their red and gold here. Now, why are we wearing all white? Good question. As you see Oklahoma State with the ball first, and that's a sick catch by Moore. Did you see him go up and get that and bring it down and keep hold of this? This is amazing. Look at this catch. Despite the hit, and he comes down with a great catch. Anyway, I'm a big fan of these Oklahoma State all gray unis, so I put those in thinking that it would accept that as a road uniform. Well, unfortunately, it didn't, and it put me in default whites. As you see a turnover there. Are you kidding me? That was an interception? Is that going to stand? Matthew Thomas picks it, but did he get that before it hit the ground? Let's take a couple looks here in slow motion. And this ball is going to the turf, but he picked it. Oh, did he trap it against the ground? Let's see one more look from the reverse angle here. Ball is out. He has it and then comes to the ground with it. They're going to say good interception. And that is Iowa State ball. They turn over the Cowboys early. Let's go now. Hand it off to White. And he is going to fight and get loose on the left-hand side there. Nice run, second and four. Let's go to him again. Again outside to the left, and he's got first down yardage. Looking good so far is James White rushing the ball. He's already got 36 yards. Okay, third and six. The pass. Ekby. Oh, he couldn't hang on to it. It'll be fourth and six. We got to call on our field goal kicker to get us a fairly decent kick here from about 41 out, and he hits it, the lefty. Boots it through, and it's 3-0 Iowa State grabbing the early lead. Here come the Cowboys, though. Shelf is going to be throwing and completing there to Blake Jackson. It'll be first down. Now we got a third and one play. Smith cannot get the first down. A big stop by the Cyclone defense, and that will bring on Oklahoma State's field goal unit to tie the game at 3. Later on here in the first half, as a matter of fact, the start of the second quarter, and James White is at it again. First down run and an 11-yard gain to the left-hand sideline. He's got 60 now. Hand off to him once again. Why not get another first down? Great effort right there. 14 yards in all, and he's above 70 yards rushing just like that. Richardson to Brunn. The tight end makes a catch for 11 yards and a first down. And the Cyclones just might be moving the ball. It's third and 10. Look out, Richardson. Yeah, he's got to throw that one away. And it's knocked down. So now a long field goal attempt. 51, I believe. It is good. And it's a 6-3 lead. Hits a 45-plus yard field goal. Gets extra points for that as far as the coaching points, experience points are concerned. I don't know, was it 51 or was it not quite that long? I guess I didn't do the exact math on there, but you can take a look at it. Third and 8. Shelf is going to throw to the end zone. Wide open is Blake Jackson for the 16-yard touchdown. My goodness, he looks more like a fullback there with that crazy neck roll he's got going underneath there. Not your conventional-looking wide receiver, but guess what? He doesn't care. He's getting open, and making plays here for Oklahoma State. So just like that, they're up 10-6. They got the ball again here late in the second quarter, Shelf. That's not a replay, but that is a sick one-handed grab by Tracy Moore. Watch the replay on this. Oh my goodness, he cradles this in over the shoulder, one-handed to secure this catch. This is a thing of beauty right here. Just snags it out of the air and hangs on when the contact comes. That's a great play, and it puts Oklahoma State up 17-6. Let's go now with just under 2 minutes left in the second quarter, and Sam Richardson loading up one-on-one. He's got his man. It's Gary. He's going to be inside the 10-yard line, first in goal. Cyclones, they finally get a big play, big strike in the passing game. They had really nothing to speak of outside of first down or two in the air, and now they get a big strike, and hopefully they can convert this into their first touchdown of the game and make this a little closer before the half. Let's see what they can do. First and goal. Richardson looking for the big tight end, Ernst Brunn, and he is in for the score. Yep, the Cyclones get right back and get a touchdown of their own. It's 17-12. This calls for a two-point conversion here to try to make it a three-point game. But first, let's look at a replay. Brunn has no problem getting into the end zone right there. He's quite a bit of a mismatch in the passing game. So going to look for pretty much the identical play. And they get it to Brunn, but he is stopped short of the goal line. No two-point conversion there. They'll have to settle for a 17-12 score. But look at this. The half is not over yet. Shelf is throwing to the end zone. They brought the blitz. And again, it's Blake Jackson standing there wide open in the end zone. Could have done jumping jacks. Could have done a flip there before he caught that ball. Instead, he just stands there and makes the catch as his quarterback gets drilled. But hey, he'll take it for a touchdown. And just like that, it's going to be 24-12 at the half. You see just 7 seconds remaining. Those will tick off. And there it is, 24-12 at the half. Oklahoma State doubling up Iowa State so far in this matchup here of Big 12 schools. I got Oklahoma State in the third quarter tacking on 3 more points to make it 27-12. And they've got the ball yet again late in the third quarter. Things not going real well for the Cyclones here. They bite on the play action and Stewart's gone. Nope, no luck right there. Josh Stewart, 36 yards out, catches this touchdown and Oklahoma State's rolling right now as we are nearing the fourth quarter. But my goodness, let's look at this again. Play action, they bit on it big time. Looked like they might have been playing bump and run, and it didn't work out so well. 34-12, Oklahoma State right now. They're kind of laughing through this second half so far as they've opened up a big lead. Now Richardson's going to try to do something about it. Take off here on his own. He's sick of balls being batted down and incomplete and whatever. He's going to run with it here. So even though we're down quite a bit, we're going to try not to forget that running game. James White finds that yardage to the left-hand side and does indeed go over 100 yards on the day with 103 on 16 carries. Nice job right there. Got to work that in still, even though we're against the clock here. 6.5 minutes left. Let's go play action. Richardson, middle of the field. It's Gary open for the touchdown. 24-yard strike, and Iowa State is not quite done yet. 34-18. Probably will go for another two-point conversion here to bring it to a 14-point game. But first, you see the replay. They find a nice seam right there in the defense and take advantage of it. So they do get back into the end zone. Two-point conversion ready to go. Richardson rolling to the right, and that's going to get picked off. Brunn was covered well. They know exactly where they want to go on that. So 34-18, still your score, and it's not taking much time for Oklahoma State to come right back down the field. And where's the defense right there? Jeremy Smith, 19-yard reception, first and goal, just outside of the goal line. Hand off to Smith, who walks into the end zone, and Oklahoma State answers just like that. It's 41-18. Yep, things pretty calm on the Oklahoma State sideline. 4:20 remaining. Richardson is going to come up a little bit short on that throw. Picked off by Stevens, and he has got a bit of a convoy going down the field. He will score. Pick six. Oklahoma State is going to round off the scoring on the day here on the Larry Stevens interception. Just like that, Oklahoma State dispatches the Cyclones. And, you know, I don't know. This team was 2-4, but they must have been playing some pretty stiff competition because you look at their ratings coming in and they were heavily rated higher in each position, each facet of the game over Iowa State. We're still hoping to build this program up. And today We're going to drop this game to Oklahoma State. I think they're a much better team than their record shows. Look at that, 356 yards passing. That'll get you player of the game. And Trash Jackson, well, you know, a few things went right. He's trying to level up to the next level here as a coach. We're not going to get there quite yet. So there's a few things to hang your hat on in this game if you're Trash Jackson looking to your team and regrouping. But it was a pretty much a beatdown, and we're going to have to just move on from that. That's part of the growing pains here, you know. Same season that we were able to beat Texas in a very low-scoring game, but, you know, the growing pains and the lumps are coming at us left and right. So we are now 3-4. It's time to go recruit. My least favorite part of NCAA 14. I wish they'd bring back the recruiting from last year. Go to my spreadsheet of numbers here. I would say I'm trying to make it about the players, but it just seems so much about numbers and buckets of points, and it seems so impersonal. So you can see my list of who I'm going after. I feel like I'm losing the feel of, you know, their overall points. I know you can sort all this stuff, but there's so much to go through here. We do have the punter, Chaz Collins. Woohoo! We got a punter named Chaz. Got that to hang our hat on. Okay. So, I don't know. You know, we're going after this quarterback that's pretty decent here, but we're kind of falling behind. So, I'm putting a couple other quarterbacks on the list, knowing that Richardson's a 79 plus one overall right now. So, more like an 80 overall. But he's just, you know, I know. Obviously, he'll grow as the program grows here and he'll progress. But we want to bring some others in behind him here. I also go get a couple corners because that defensive secondary, it was rough out there today. It just really showed us what we need to improve on there. We defensive secondary, defense all around. Yeah, we need some help back there. So just allotting some points here the best I can, and we'll see how it goes with recruiting. So if we have another breakthrough with somebody here that wants to sign on, we will highlight them. But for now, Iowa State loses in week 9. They fall to 3-4. We're going to go ahead and advance this week. It doesn't get any easier because we're going to have to go to Kansas State next and play. I believe they're 4-2 at this point. And you see the recruiting battles we're in with four different guys here, two being kickers. Yeah, I know we need a kicker, but I mean, how depressing it is that we're fighting for just kickers here. We need really impact players. So, yeah, there you go. Kansas State now 5-2 as we advance. And, yes, it is a tough road ahead. So, Iowa State will fight on. You know, I'm kind of looking to get the recruits in here and look forward to next season. I don't even know if we'll make a bowl game with all this stiff Big 12 competition. But we'll definitely give it a go. Come on back for the next Iowa State episode, and we will see you then.